American Motors, builders of Rambler, Nash, and Hudson Automobiles, and Kelvinator Home Appliances. And Swift, makers of Swift's premium new frozen packaged meats, fries, and poultry. Look to Swift for the finest. Swift to serve your family better. Present Walt Disney's Disneyland.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
Each week as you enter this timeless land, one of these many worlds will open to you. Frontierland. Tall tales and true from the legendary past. Tomorrowland. Promise of things to come. Adventureland, the wonder world of nature's own realm. Fantasyland, the happiest kingdom of them all. Presenting this week from Fantasyland, Goofy's Cavalcade of Sports.
What is a nice couple like you doing in an argument?
He wants a big, big car with lots of room inside. But a car like that is so big and clumsy in traffic, I just can't handle it.
Yeah, and she wants one of those little foreign cars. It's easy to handle and park. But where do you put the family? On the roof?
But what about the new kind of car? The only one that has big car room and comfort with small car convenience and economy. The car of new dimensions, the 1957 Rambler. Rambler has plenty of room for six-footers to stretch out and relax. Yet it's so compact, it outturns and outparks every other car made in America. And Rambler has the power and economy news of the year. You can choose Rambler's new V8 engine with 190 blazing horsepower, or Rambler's improved Economy 6 that travel coast to coast on less than a penny a mile for gas. Fun test the 57 Rambler at your Nash dealer, at your Hudson dealer.
And now, here is your host, Walt Disney.
On this program, we bring you the Goofy Cavalcade of Sports. Sports originated from man's instinct for self-preservation. To be able to run, fight, throw, or swim better than the other fellow often meant the difference between life and death to primitive man. Sports have an interesting history. As man acquired more leisure, he adapted these basic actions into games. The games became highly organized. Rules and training became important. And people throughout the world took a keen interest in sports and sports heroes. So, we present our sportsman, Goofy, who in his own way makes sports history.
In boxing, in swimming, basketball, golf. Yes, Goofy makes headlines in all sports. In fact, he makes his own headlines.
Yep, I'm gonna save them, too.
Well, perhaps Goofy isn't really the sports hero. His headlines make him, but he is a keen student of all sports and keeps a careful record in his scrapbook. Let's take a look inside this fabulous Goofy collection and start with a gentle art of self-defense. In the beginning, primitive man used clubs to settle his grudges. Down through the ages, the cold, unrelenting law of nature has been, and still is, the survival of the fittest. Now that man has become a gentleman, he prefers to settle his quarrels with gloves. Out of this period, along about 1681, historians agree the birth of modern fighting took place in England.
Quite right, old chap. We British delighted to settle our grudges with our fists, just for the sport of it. Our first real champion was James Figg, who changed fighting from the rough and tumble style to bare-knuckle boxing. And you know, it was Figg who opened the first school to teach the gentry the rudiments of the noble art of self-defense. And soon more schools were established. And it wasn't long before bare-knuckle fighting became the rage of the times. However, the sport was still a bit rough. And we British were perturbed with such unfair tactics. And so, in 1743, Jack Broughton, known as the father of boxing, formulated the first set of rules, which became known as the London Prize Ring Rules.
No person is to hit his adversary while he is down, nor seize him by the hair or breeches. If a man stay down within the space of half a minute, he shall be deemed a beaten man. Two umpires, chosen from among the gentlemen.
Under these rules of good sportsmanship, the art of fisticuffs became quite fashionable with the aristocracy. Fighters were much admired by the gentry. And to be declared champion meant fame and fortune.
Righto.
Bravo. Oh. Meanwhile, the interest of our American cousins in the sport had been awakened too.
Yes, some great American fighters came along. Morrissey, Allen, Paddy Ryan, down to the great John L. Sullivan, the Boston strong boy. It was Sullivan who popularized the use of the Marquess of Queensbury rules and boxing gloves. Even so, these early bouts were a crude form of fisticuffs, often lasting only 70 or 80 rounds. Actually, there were tests of endurance for the spectators as well as the fighters. Then came the dawn of the modern era. Boxing is now big business. Behind every fighter today, you'll find worried managers, press agents, plenty of sparring partners, and even psychiatrists. Then there's the muscle-building equipment, all housed in a modern gymnasium and all dedicated to just one objective, the training and conditioning of the modern fighter.
Science marches on.
Picture of a man beside himself with indecision.
Should I buy a big car that has lots of room but is hard to handle and expensive to operate? Or should I get one of those little foreign cars that are easy to turn, park, and garage, but just don't have enough room for an ordinary family? What's a fella to do?
Compose yourself. Don't you know there's one car that has everything? Big car room and comfort, plus small car convenience and economy. It's the 57 Rambler, the car of new dimensions. Rambler is so compact, the station wagon outturns every sedan made in America. Yet the Rambler cross-country station wagon has full room for six big passengers plus king-size cargo space. Rambler gives big car performance, too. Watch as the new V8 races a strip of high explosives. Even on regular gas, it goes like wildfire. Or choose Rambler's new improved Economy 6, 32 miles per gallon coast-to-coast with overdrive. Fun test the 57 Rambler at your Nash dealer, at your Hudson dealer.
Well, now that we've learned all about boxing, let's just see what else the Goofy Library has to offer.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Say, how about fishing? Let's tell them about fishing.
Ah, yes, fishing. fishing is a fascinating science.
when to fish can be determined by the astrological signs of the zodiac, whose countless stars and planets control all the tides of the Earth's waters.
Watch it! Now watch it! Watch it! Don't let him get back in the water!
Truly, no pride is so justifiable as that of a successful fisherman.
Yep. Nothing to it. When I hook 'em, they stay hooked. What does a fish know about fishing?
Hold on, Goofy. Man can learn a lot from the fish, like swimming. Swimming is one of the most healthful exercises devised. There is no record of who was the first human to swim, nor how he learned. But it is safe to assume that man first got the idea from watching the fish. So let's go back to the beginning and learn all about it. In the beginning, the world was all wet. Today, it is still four-fifths wet. Primitive man, in the course of his migrations, often encountered bodies of water too wide or too deep to be crossed. As early as 880 BC, inflated goatskins were used as water wings by these Assyrian fugitives as an aid to swimming. Here is the Egyptian symbol for swim. These ancient symbols depict various styles of swimming. The dog paddle, the breaststroke, and the side stroke. Early Grecian coins recorded the first great channel swim, when Leander swam the Hellespont to visit his lady love. As swimming developed, so did the bathing costume. From nudity to vanity, bathing suits ran the gamut from the ridiculous to the sublime, and back to the ridiculous.
Perhaps no one factor has contributed so greatly to the current popularity of swimming as has the sensible bathing suit. It should not be too daring, yet bold enough to allow freedom of movement. As the setting sun slowly dips into the azure blue of the western sea, reluctantly, we close on this tranquil scene with the firm conviction that everyone should learn how to swim.
Ice cream, the fun food the whole family loves. Any day's a party day when there's ice cream on the table. It's pure pleasure, especially with cherries, featured in February. You'll enjoy a slice of vanilla topped with bright cherry sauce. And who could resist this double cherry parfait made with alternate layers of cherry sauce and cherry vanilla ice cream? Pretty enough for any party. Serve cherries with ice cream, the fun food the whole family loves. Celebrate with ice cream at your house today. Just be sure you take home enough for everybody.
Cool, man, cool.
Golf, like all sports, has had a very interesting past. Many games have gotten their start from such simple things as a stick and a stone. For example, hockey, polo, cricket, baseball, and most naturally, golf, which some historians believe is derived from the Dutch word kolf, meaning club, and that the game originated on the frozen canals of Holland.
Man, I've never heard such a ridiculous statement. Everybody kens that golf is a national game of Scotland. Aye, and back in the 1500s, King James IV gave the game his royal sanction. Even though his form left much to be desired. And Mary, Queen of Scotland, she was one of the first woman golfers. Twas she who used cadets to fetch and carry her clubs. The French called cadets cadets, or caddies, the word we use to this very day. And look ye here, St. Andrews, the first and most famous golf club. Twas founded in Scotland in 1552, and down through the years, it's come to be the most famous club in the world. Aye, and 'twas the Scots gave America the game, too.
Right you are, Scotty. John Reed, a Scotsman, of course, founded the first American golf club at Yonkers, New York, in 1888. We promptly called it Cow Pasture Pool. Here, beneath the shade of the old apple tree, was the original 19th hole, with a basket of sandwiches and a demijohn of Scottish dew to refresh a weary foursome. The popularity of the game increased, and golf clubs sprang up all over the country. Thus, from a simple stick and a stone, the stone has now become a ball, able to withstand the roughest kind of treatment. Though why, we'll never know, for statistics show that more than 9,200,000 golf balls are lost in the rough every year. Well, anyway, the stick has now become a bewildering assortment of clubs. And now, let's see how the game is played.
Out in the green open fields where a man can get away from it all. Happily, the golfer chooses his club. Having covered the course, we come at last to the 19th hole, where we join our friends in the proverbial bull session that ends a perfect day of golf.
Time now to tell you ladies how to keep father happy when he starts looking for something to eat during those long TV commercials. Here's the makings of a real man-type steak sandwich, and you fix it in 4 minutes flat. It's true. Swift's premium ready-quick sandwich steaks will have you back to your TV set in no time. Without thawing, you just zip Swift's premium sandwich steaks out of their aluminum foil wrapper and into a hot pan. 2 minutes on one side, 2 minutes on the other side. Place them between slices of bread and serve. They're juicy, lean, red meat. All meat. You eat every bit you buy. For quick fixing snacks anytime, get tender frozen Swift's premium sandwich steaks. Look for all these tender frozen Swift's premium meats. Sandwich steaks, loin luncheon steaks, buttered beef steaks, and hamburger patties. If they're not at your food store, they'll be there soon. From Swift, to serve your family better.
Boxing, fishing, swimming, golf. These are all individual sports. Now let's consider a game that takes athletes and welds them into a team. Basketball. Basketball is a Native American game, as American as the Star Spangled Banner. It originated in Springfield, Massachusetts in 1892. Before basketball, there existed a need for an indoor winter substitute for football and baseball. Gymnasiums were unable to fill this need with dull classes and calisthenics. Members soon became bored and attendance dwindled. Gymnasiums faced a real problem. In answer to this problem, the new game, as it was originally called, was created in the fertile brain of one man, Dr. James Naismith, who worked for many weeks making drawings, diagrams, and drafting rules.
First, I tried to modify existing games so they could be played indoors. Football, with its kicking, running, and tackling, was too rough. And baseball didn't lend itself to indoor play. However, a ball was an essential of all team games. But how to use the ball? To replace the kickoff, I thought of the center jump. To check running and tackling, I devised the dribble. Then there was the problem of boundaries and how to score. Now, I reasoned that everyone enjoys throwing something at a target, but what to use for a target? This really had me stumped. Then, quite by accident, I found the answer. A peach basket.
And that's how the game got its name, basketball. A YMCA assistant would hang a peach basket high on the gym balcony and retrieve all balls shot into it. This was more or less impractical.
Out!
So a hole was made in the bottom of the basket, allowing the ball to pass through. Later, a wire wastebasket was used. And finally came the metal hoop with its net as we know it today. Basketball today is the world's number one sport. Throughout the world, it has more than 20 million players, not a few of them women. And its rules have been translated into 30 different languages. From basketball's humble beginnings in 1892, gymnasiums and auditoriums have mushroomed in size to accommodate the thousands of enthusiastic cage fans who flock to see their favorite teams play. Let's go inside and see how the game is played.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to witness the basketball battle of the century. The whole town has turned out to back the local team from University U, and Polytechnic University from upstate is well supported, too. The UUPU rivalry dates back to the beginning of the century, and up to now, the score is even, and tonight's battle is a toss-up between these two squads. Marathew shoots. And he's in. I mean, it's in. Yes, yes. And there's the final gun. PU 36, UU 35. The upstate boys really came through, and just listen to those PU fans.
Hail to victory for all PU.
Hello, I'm Doris Drew. Being a professional singer, I often have days when I just seem to be running around in circles. My husband walks in the door and I haven't even started dinner yet. Well, that's the time I rely on Ready Quick Swift's Premium Tender Frozen Meats for delicious meals in minutes. For example, Swift's Premium Buttered Beef Steaks. Juicy chop steaks that are buttered to make them extra delicious. All lean meat, no waste. Ready to eat in 10 minutes. Cook without thawing. Serve with heat and eat French fries and a quick fixing vegetable, and you've got a delicious dinner in minutes. Keep tender frozen Swift's Premium Buttered Beef Steaks on hand in your freezer, along with Swift's Premium Sandwich Steaks, Loin Luncheon Steaks, Hamburger Patties, or French Veal Cutlets. If you don't see these new Swift meats at your food store, keep asking for them. They'll be there soon. From Swift to serve your family better.
Our program next week will come to you from Fantasyland. We'll take you behind the scenes in our animated cartoon studio and show you some of the tricks of our trade.
Next week, Walt Disney brings you another chapter in the fascinating story of animation. It's called Tricks of Our Trade. In it, you will see how, in the early days of film animation, Disney artists literally taught themselves how to give cartoon characters and backgrounds the semblance of life. Nothing was too large or too small for their inquiring minds. They made slow motion studies of shattering glass. A medicine dropper and some milk showed them the secret of a raindrop, so they could bring you this delightful sequence from Bambi. How the seven dwarfs got their unique personalities will be shown, too, when you see this episode from Snow White.
Now, don't tell me who you are. Let me guess. You're sneezy. And you must be...
Happy, ma'am. That's me. And this is Dopey. He don't talk none.
Oh, you must be grumpy.
The huge main camera was specially designed to give depth.
Look, he's trying to get up.
Join a Disney art class studying caricature and satire.
While a model demonstrates steps in classical ballet, the artists adapt it to their own uses to create the characters for the dance of the hours. See the Dance of the Hours, along with complete sequences from Bambi, Fantasia, and Snow White, next week, when Walt Disney brings you Tricks of Our Trade.
Guess which hands hold Tinkerbell? There she is. Hi, Tink. Now, guess which hands hold Peter Pan? Not there. Not there. Where's Peter Pan?
We want Peter Pan!
Ah, here we are. New, smoother Peter Pan peanut butter.
Your eyes know, your tummy knows. Best of all, your taster knows. Peter Pan peanut butter is so grand. The smoothest peanut butter in the land.
Made a new way, smoother than ever. Even the cap is new. It unscrews. And there's a new seal of purity that seals Peter Pan fresh, to stay fresh. Mmm, so smooth. Spreads faster than you can say Peter Pan.
Peter Pan peanut butter is so grand, the smoothest peanut butter in the land.
Next week, Disneyland will be brought to you by your local dairy farmers in this area through the American Dairy Association, reminding you to drink 1, 2, 3 glasses of milk a day. You never outgrow your need for milk. And Peter Pan peanut butter, now made a new way. It's the smoothest spreading in the land. Walt Disney's Cinderella, that wondrous full-length cartoon feature, is coming soon to a theater near you. Cinderella, that ever-wonderful, ageless love story, is coming to delight and entertain you again and again. You'll rediscover the happiness and merriment, the fun and fantasy of this best love story in one of the most enchanting motion pictures ever made. Cinderella, spun of dreams, laughter, and romance, enriched with delightful music to put a smile in your heart. Walt Disney's Cinderella, all in color by Technicolor, coming to a theater near you soon. This has been an ABC Television Network film presentation.